Good morning students, welcome to computer class of 9th standard. Today we will discuss chapter 1, introduction to object oriented programming concepts. As in the last video we have discussed about what is a program, what do you mean by programmer, what is programming, programming language and evolution of programming languages. Today we will discuss programming paradigms, POP, that is procedure oriented programming, OOP, that is object oriented programming, difference between object oriented programming and procedure oriented programming, limitations of procedure oriented programming and limitations of object oriented programming. And this we will discuss through page number 4, 5, 6 and 7. Start with the definition of programming paradigms. An approach or style of programming that is used to classify programming languages means on the basis of syntax and rules we can classify the programming languages, that is called programming paradigms. The next definition is procedure-oriented programming, POP. It is very clear with the name. Procedure means functions, small modules. A paradigm where a complex programming is solved by dividing it into smaller problems using functions. Means a lengthy program is divided into small functions and then it should be solved. The next definition is object-oriented programming, that is OOP, a paradigm in which data and functions are wrapped into a single unit. Means in which a full program is packed with the help of data and functions, that is wrapped into a single unit. Next we will discuss the difference between object oriented programming and procedure oriented programming. Number 1, procedure oriented or structure oriented. As it is based on procedures or functions, so it is procedure oriented. In case of object oriented programming, as it is based on real world objects or real world entities like car, bank account, pencil, book, so it is object oriented. Number 2, procedure oriented programming follows top down approach. As in case of C language, when program is created, first main method will be there because there is no class. Firstly, main method is there and then the number of functions. As execution will start from the main method, so it will follow the top-down approach, means main function execute and then number of methods. In case of object-oriented programming, it follows bottom-up approach. As in object-oriented programming like Java, there will be a class declaration, then instance variables will be declared, then methods and then the main method. As execution will start from the main method, but it is coming at the last after class declaration, objects declaration, instance variables, so it follows the bottom-up approach. Number 3, main focus is on how to get the task done. So focus is there how to solve a particular problem. In case of object-oriented programming, the main focus is on data security. As data security is implemented through abstraction and encapsulation, because data and functions are wrapped into a single unit, so no other user can access the data. So data is secured. Number 4, large program is divided into functions. So a single program is divided into number of parts to complete the task. In case of object-oriented programming, entire program is divided into objects. Firstly, the main class will be declared, and after that, number of objects will be created that belong to a same class. Number 5, no access specifier observed, like public, private or protected. In case of object-oriented programming, access specifiers are used, like public, private and protected. Means data is not moved throughout the program. Example, in case of object-oriented programming like C language, VB, that is Visual Basic, Fortran, that is called Formula Translation, and Pascal. In case of object-oriented programming, the example is C++, Java, and VB.NET, etc. So, that is the difference between procedure-oriented programming and object-oriented programming. Next, we will discuss the limitations of procedure-oriented programming. Procedural codes are very difficult to maintain if the code grows longer. Means, if the length of the program will be increased, means there will be a number of functions, then it is very difficult to maintain the code. Like in the case of C language, if your functions have increased till 10,000 lines, it will be very difficult to create that program. Number 2, data moved freely in the program as there is no access specifier, so no security of the data. Number 3, difficult to create new data types, as in Java there are some basic data types like int, float, char, byte, long. And we can create user-defined data types also. But in case of procedure-oriented programming, there are only limited data types and new data types is difficult to create. Number 4, limited and difficult code reusability. Code reusability means as one function is created, it is very difficult to use it again and again. So, it is very difficult in case of procedure-oriented programming. Number 5, it does not model the real-world entities. Example, car, table, bank account. These type of programming is very difficult in case of procedure-oriented programming that is based on real-world. Whereas, human being perceives everything as an object. So, these are some limitations of procedure-oriented programming. The next are the limitations of object-oriented programming. The programmer should have a proper planning before designing a program using object-oriented programming approach. This means that as object-oriented programming is based on the objects, so the programmer who is creating the program, he should be pre-planned in their mind about the objects. Which objects he will use in the program, the type of objects and the number of objects. Since everything is treated as an object in object-oriented programming, the programmer need proper skills such as designing skills, programming skills. He should be well prepared with their thinking skills how to create the different objects according to their requirement of the program. The size of the program developed with object-oriented programming is larger than the procedural approach because it is based on the real-world objects. So, the length of the program is increased according to the objects we will use in the program. Object-oriented programming code is difficult to understand if you do not have the corresponding class documentation. Class documentation means after creating a class in Java, there will be a proper class documentation for each and every part of a program with the help of comments. That what is the use of variables, use of methods. With the help of class documentation, the user can easily understand the object-oriented programming code. So students, today we have discussed programming paradigms, procedure-oriented programming, object-oriented programming, and we have discussed the topic programming paradigms, POP, OOP, difference between OOP and POP, then limitations of POP and limitations of OOP. So students, revise the topic carefully, object-oriented programming and procedure-oriented programming. Understand the difference between them. And in the next video, we will come with next topic. Thank you very much.